Junior High School family, I extend deepest sympathy the family of Lahoma, especially her children, her siblings, and Mr. Stewart. Hopkins was so special to S.E. McPherson. Hopkins was my personal secretary. She was also the office manager. She will be greatly missed. As a matter of fact, this is from the Hopkins name. Hopkins will be greatly missed. And so, in memory to her, the administration and the students will render a selection in her honor. May her soul forever rest in peace.
Thank you. amen.
Amen.
And let's give Essie McPherson another round of applause. God bless you. We thank God for you for taking good care of Sister Lahoma. Come on, give them another round. Thank you. You know, Lahoma loved to worship. She loved to sing the songs of Zion. She loved to express how much she loved the Lord through singing. Amen? We want to prepare our hearts to receive the word of God today. Before Bishop Simmons comes on, we're going to sing "I'll Fly Away," this closing, this congregational hymn. Before Bishop Simmons comes, I want everyone to stand, and we want to just worship God in this last song before the word comes on. I don't know about you, but this is a good place to worship. Look at someone and say, this is a good place to worship. Amen. I'll fly away.
Thank you. trust that this homegoing service that we are experiencing here today is a blessing to you, that it serves as a reminder that death is a certainty that all of us have to face. And it is certain that if we have to face death, and like it was quoted here many times today, after that time, it is the judgment. I greet all of these ministers that are here, present on the platform today, especially Reverend Apostle Christopher Russell, who's the senior pastor of the Christian Tabernacle Church, all of the other ministers that are here, from the Seven Hills Church and our Rugen Roads Church. And I certainly bring you greetings to this occasion that we are celebrating the life of Lahoma Hopkins. The Seven Hills family, of where she attended every now and again and promised me she would do better every time she came. And this being her last day, and I guess she lived up to her promise. I bring greetings on behalf of the Seven Hills family, of my family, and all of us who are praying for this bereaved family, that you will allow the God who helped you, who brought you from April, I think it was 16 when it was her demise, up to this present time, let him continue to hold you, sustain you, and keep you. You've been here for quite a long time already, and I, for one, will not keep you long. Most of you don't know it, but there's a law in the Bahamas that you can't bury people after sunset. And apparently, if you violate the law, they don't come looking for you or the bereaved family. They come looking for the presiding minister, the officiating minister. I can assure you I have no money to pay fines, and so I won't keep you so that I will be charged. But if you will bear with me just for a few more moments, I would like to share a word from the Lord with you. James 1 and 17 tells us, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Malachi chapter 3, verse 6 tells us, for I am the Lord, I change not. Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed. Psalms 145 and 13 tells us, the kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and thy dominion endureth throughout all generations. Revelations 11 and 15 tells us, and the seventh angel sounded, and there were great voices in heaven saying, the kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our God and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever. Psalms chapter 90 and 2 tells us, before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hadst formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. The scriptures that were read in your hearing is supposed to point to you that we have a God who changes not. We are living in a world that is changing times. I want you to grab hold of your neighbor and say, neighbor. Oh, neighbor. The best thing about you is you can change. Neighbor. Yes, you, neighbor. The worst thing about you is you can change. Not one of you sitting in this room will be the same next week. You will be a couple of days older. You will be a couple of days, we will hope, wiser. You may get some more gray hairs. Certainly this bereaved family has been changed forever. Because our loved one is no longer in your house. She's no longer a phone call away. She's no longer on the list to be invited to club meetings. What's the matter? Something has happened. Change has occurred in your life. We, with our smart selves, think that the thing that to accommodate change, we go to something else that's changing. But I'm here to tell you that if you are going to change, you're going to have to hold on to something that cannot change. And that's who I've come to introduce to you today. I've come to tell you about the God who changes not. The God who is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The same God who told you, people who